Hi there, welcome to Kevvy Shaves, very nice to see you. If you're watching this video, this is the short version of my review of the new Blackland adjustable. This razor is called the Osprey. So, thanks for watching this video, this is the short version. So, let's get into the review. The cream for today is Cella. I'm going to be bowl lathering that in the Captain's Choice bowl. So there's the cream in there. The brush is the Phoenix Starcraft with the 24mm Roswell Synth knot. Here's the brush here, very nice brush, I like this brush. Yeah, so that's the brush. The blade I'm going to be using, the blade is the Gillette Ruby, brand new Gillette Ruby blade. The razor for today's shave is the brand new Blackland Osprey, the adjustable. Yeah, I've done a kind of unboxing review of this, which I'll put the link to in the video. It has all the specs and it shows you everything in detail about this razor. So that's what I'm going to be using for today's shave. And I'll put it through, it's an adjustable, goes 1-9, so I'll put it through its paces, just using different settings and stuff like that, and see how I could change it on the fly and during the shave and stuff like that. So we'll do that. Let's get this lathered with this brush. How are you? How's things? Yeah, I'm looking forward to this review. It's all about the razor today, so just giving you my thoughts on it, seeing how it performs, see how it feels. Is it aggressive? Is it really not aggressive on the lower settings and stuff like that? So, yeah, I'm just giving you my thoughts on it. But there will be another 2 or 3 videos using this just to get a general feel for it. Today I have about 5 days worth of stubble here, so I just wanted to kind of test it out with different lengths of stubble and different, I might shave again after a day, stuff like that. So just for the next few shaves I'll be using this razor just to test it out, give me my thoughts on it. Here's the razor here, 3-piece. Screw the handle like that, comes off, head comes off like that. There's all there. Yeah, so there's our Gillette Ruby. So it just goes on the top cap like that. There's there. That goes on like that. You push that on. Screw the handle on. And there's there. I'll adjust it before I start the shave. See, the blade looks all nicely aligned. Yeah, beautiful razor. Good weight to this. It weighs 105 grams. If you take this brass insert out, see this little brass insert, it weighs 88 grams. So a little bit lighter, but really nice, looks good. Right, let's get lathered up. Right, let's go for the setting. So here's the arrow here. So this arrow here tells you what setting you're on. So to adjust it, you loosen the handle and then you turn it to, let's go setting 5. And then you tighten the handle back up. So there's our on setting 5, halfway. Can you see that? Yep. Right, let's see how this feels. Right, I can't feel the blade, so yeah, I can't really feel the blade. It's getting towards Blackbird territory for me. The Blackland Blackbird, if you know how that feels, it's kind of heading that way. It's not as aggressive as that on 5. Okay, let's just turn it up to setting. Let's go to 7. Setting 7. Right, let's see how this feels. Yeah, straight away you can feel the difference. There's more blade feel. not a great ton of blade feel, but yeah, it feels nice. Okay, let's take it up to let's take it right up to 9. That's up as far as it will go, up to setting 9, which is the most aggressive. Look at that gap. Yeah, you see that there? Look at that. I think that blade gap is 1.4 millimeters. So let's see how that feels. Yeah. Yeah, you can feel the blade there. And it's just wiping away that stubble. So a good range. Right, I'll turn it back down. Just loosen the handle. There's little bits here on the side which is good for gripping. Actually, it doesn't feel slippy. Let's take it right back down to let's go all the way back down to 1. Setting 1. Yeah, that's mild. But you know what? It's removing the whiskers, which is what you want a razor to do. So there we go, that was on setting 1. Yeah, you can see the difference there in the blade gap. There's hardly any showing there. But that was good. Felt nice. Right, let's have a feel. Yeah, this sight feels a little bit closer because I think I used that on setting 9, so but all in all, feels great.
Right.
Okay, pass number 2 with the Blackland Osprey. Right, so I finished up the first pass on setting 1, so here's how easy it is to, people say, oh, I don't like that, you have to change it, you have to unscrew the handle to change it. You would do that with a Gillette adjustable as well, wouldn't you? You kind of turn the dial so the doors release a little bit, then you adjust it. So this, you just turn the handle and I'll go to setting, let's go to 4, and then just tighten the handle down. Yeah, so setting 4. You can see that on the arrow there, on the other side has Blackland. So setting 4 for the second pass. That is very comfortable. Yeah, there's no overhang on this razor, so safe. Going under the nose and stuff. Right, again, let's adjust it. Just loosen the handle and take it up to setting. Let's go 7.5. Yeah, someone said in the comments of the last video, it would be nice if the numbers were painted. And I have to agree, I think the numbers do look great, and that might take away from, if they were painted, it might take away from the overall look from the stainless steel finished. But you could clearly see the numbers, but it would just might be nice if they were painted. But I suppose you could do that yourself, I guess. There's lots of videos on there. But the weight and balance of this razor is, it's nice to hold. It feels, it's evenly balanced. It's not too head heavy. Again, but if you take the brass section out here, which is easy to do, it will make it a little bit more head heavy. So let's go on setting, what did I say, 7.5? Well, just after 7. Right. Again, that feels nice. It doesn't feel overly aggressive because it's very smooth. It's very smooth in use. Yeah, set in 7, or just after 7. Maybe 7.2. Great, feels really nice. Very smooth. So that was on just above setting 7. Let's go from setting 7 for the Against the Growth pass. Let's take it down to setting, let's go to 3. Let's go to setting 3. I'll just turn the handle again. Yeah, some people might think that unscrewing the handle like this and then adjusting it with the blade there might be a bit dangerous. So if you want to use like a towel to hold it, that might be a better idea, but no issues with grip at all with this handle. It feels really nice, really grippy with these little bits in here. Yeah, very good. Right, setting 3 Against the Growth with the Blackland Osprey. Yeah, so setting 3 for me on this feels about setting plate 3 on the Rockwell 6S, maybe even a little bit less. If there was a plate 2.5, that's what this would feel like. Very nice. Of course, it depends if you like a lot of blade feel. Which I don't. I don't like too much blade feel. Setting 3 for me feels great, especially against the Growth. Yeah, I don't like a lot of blade feel, so I tend to go more towards a milder shave. So this setting feels great, setting 3. Yeah, very nice. It's very smooth. There's not any blade feel. Right, so for the pickups, let's go to setting, let's go all the way to 9. Setting 9, just tighten that back down. Yeah, look at that gap. Right, so there's just a... Yeah, there's a bit of blade feel there. But it's smooth. If you like the Blackland Blackbird, you'll probably love this razor because it has some of the characteristic feel of that, but it also has this, the blade feel is that as well, and especially on these higher settings. For the short version, I'll give you my final thoughts on this razor. Right, the good points, the bad points, everything in between. The good points, it's great balance, it's very smooth. The range in the adjuster is very good, 1 to 9, one very mild. You can even feel it if you move it up like a notch or two, you feel the difference. Setting 9, there's a lot of blade feel there. Setting 4 was great, 3 was great. The thing about this, I'm not sure about loosening the handle. This dial is very tight, which is great. But I think, I'm not sure if there's going to be a lot of guys with sliced fingers adjusting this, because it is quite tight as you get up to the higher numbers. So just be careful if you're adjusting it. If you do get this and you're adjusting it kind of like that, once you loosen the handle, yeah, the adjuster's quite tight to move, which is good. I like that. But just be careful while holding this. I know there is little ridges there, but yeah, you need to watch your fingers. Some people are going to slice their fingers, I guarantee it. But good balance, good weight. Yeah, it's a nice razor. As I say, the range in the numbers when adjusting it is very good. You get a good difference in the, if you like a milder shave or a more aggressive shave. I'm going to try it again with maybe 1 or 2 days growth, see how I got on with that. Just try it on the lower set and see how it performs with that. But that's my thoughts on, initially, on the Blackland Osprey. Yeah, very good. But you'll see it in the next video. So for those watching the short version, thank you, and I'll see you next time.